Hey everyone, I'm back once again with another video. For this week's video, I will be talking about a collab game that me and paypercutts were working on for quite some time now. In short, it is a tower defense based game set in the future. I have talked more in depth about it in my previous video. If you want to know more information about the game, be sure to check out the last video. Okay, so in this video, I will be talking about all the different improvements that I was working on for the past 2 weeks. Now, the last time I was working on the game was around a month ago, during one of my live streams. During the live stream, we have started to implement and add different turrets into the game. For now, we have two different turrets implemented. So the first turret is a heavy-based singular turret that we added into the game. And the second turret that we added as well was a slightly less different version of the first turret. It's just that the second turret actually shoots from two spots instead of one. To fully implement the turrets, I have to rewrite the scripting logic for the turrets. As before, the turrets could only shoot from one spot. The next feature to implement was the turret's health system. I have talked with paypercutts and we decided to make that the turrets would have health too, and that the turrets could be destroyed by the enemies. This was quite simple to do as I used the same code that I have used for the enemies. So I added the same health script to the turrets, changed a few bits, and we were ready to go. Okay, so now the enemies can attack and destroy the turrets. The enemies are still following the path to destroy the HQ, but along the way they stop by any near turrets and try to destroy them. Now this might change in the future as the enemies now stay still by the turrets that they're attacking and only move if the turret is destroyed. What should happen instead is that the enemy would need to go to the HQ directly and shoot at the turrets as they're passing by instead of just stopping by them. I will have to leave this fixed for the next time. Okay, and the last bit that I did is I started to implement the logic and scripts for the animations, mainly the death animations. Papercuts has sent me tons of different death animations of different turrets and enemies, so I started to work on the script. After some work on the script, now the death animations are implemented. For now, I only have the HQ death animations implemented. But to implement the rest of the animations, it shouldn't take too long, or it shouldn't be too hard. And the last small bit that I implemented was the logic for the shop system. So now, if you don't have enough money, you won't be able to place any turrets that are priced at a higher amount than the money that you currently have. This was quite simple and a fast fix as well. Okay, so now that we're done with this week's implementations, we can talk about what we're going to be doing for next time. Just before we get into this, what I have decided to do is to be a bit more organized with the tasks that I have to do for the game. Before, I used to just load up the project and try to implement features that I think about just on the spot. Now what I have decided to do is I have decided to make one of those Trello boards. I feel that by having this Trello task management board, I will be able to come up with new things to do and focus on current existing tasks that need to be done. So now that we have the simple version of the task board, we can actually try to decide what we need to work on for the next time. I think I will try to take some small things from the to-do list and add them to the existing tasks that I'm currently working on. I think we can take the adding the flamethrower turret type and fixing the rotation of the enemies as they pass by. As for now we only have two turret types and we need to add the third turret type that paypercutts have sent me the textures for. And for now when the enemies are passing by, they only turn around when they're close to the target. And they should instead turn when they're shooting at the target and should focus towards the target. Of course, we need to finish the current ones that I was working on. I need to finish the implementation of the death animations, and I need to fix so that the enemies would go directly to the HQ instead of just stopping by the turret. Okay, that's perfect. Now we know what we're going to be doing for the next update video. Alright, let's go to the second part of the video now. The second part this time is going to be a short one. I just wanted to talk about my schedule for the videos that I will be uploading here on YouTube. Okay, so the plan is to upload one development video every 2 weeks for both of the games. The two games being the tower defense collab game that we talked about in this video, and the other game being the endless runner type of a game that I was developing and talking about in my previous video as well. So the whole idea is basically this. For 2 weeks, I will be working on one of the projects, and then I will be swapping to the next one. So this week, I was working on the tower defense game, and now that this video is done and 2 weeks have passed, for the next 2 weeks, I will be working on the endless running astronaut game. I'm planning to do these rotational type of videos. In this way, I can both make and upload videos, and both continue working on the games and make progress. Alright, so for the next 2 weeks, I will be working on Endless Runner Astronaut game. I should really think of a name for the game, but anyways, for now, I will be working on the game, and I will upload another development video similar to this one, or for the Astronaut game instead. Okay, as usual, thanks a lot for watching, be sure to follow my Twitter, Instagram, and join my Discord server. See you on the next video.